how much does it cost to set up a small-scale mushroom farm? I get asked that question a heck of a lot. So in this video, we're going to take you through about how much it's going to cost for you to set up a mushroom grow, which will produce between about 30 to 50 kgs of mushrooms per week. I think that 30 to 50 kgs per week is the sweet spot for one person to operate at a small-scale mushroom farm. We're going to break this down into five parts. We're going to cover off the fruiting, the lab, the incubation, the pre and post production, and then any additional costs that the farm might incur. So let's crack on.
Now that is a knife hand that would make General Mattis proud.
And see just how much this is going to cost. So for any small scale mushroom farm, the first thing you need to build is a fruiting room or a fruiting chamber. This is my fruiting room here, and it can hold about 150 blocks. My blocks are on a 3-week cycle, which means they come in, they flush once, they flush twice, and then I move them out of there. Now, to build a fruiting chamber, there's going to be a few things that'll cost you money. The first, you actually have to construct the room.
Construction of the fruiting room can be as easy or as complex as you like. If you aim for 12 square metres, you should be able to produce 30 kilos of mushrooms. The cheapest, easiest, and fastest way is to get an indoor hydroponics grow tent. Expect these to set you back about $350 for a 9 meter square grow space.
The second, you need to humidify the room.
I built my own humidifier, which costs around $250. I have a video of it linked in the corner. Alternatively, you can purchase a hydrofogger, which does the same thing for about $350.
The third, you need lights in the room.
You can get 150 watts of good, strong LEDs and a Meanwell driver for about $120.
The fourth, you need an exhaust fan for the room.
An exhaust fan with some ducting will set you back about $90.
And the fifth is a shelving to grow your mushrooms on. This is my shelving here and I made that myself, but it's probably a bit easier just to buy shelving.
You can buy shelving for about $65 a piece. Or you can make your own like mine. I'll put a link to my build in the top right hand corner.
So once all these things are done, you can expect the fruiting chamber to set you back about
$1,500 minimum. It is very easy to go over this mark when you add in all the small things you need to buy.
The mushroom lab. The mushroom lab can consist of a pretty basic setup. Ideally, you want to choose an existing room that has concrete or vinyl floors, and you need a few key things in here. The first and the most important is a laminar flow hood, like what I've got right here. The purpose of your flow hood is to pump air through it, and these HEPA filters in here actually take out all the contamination out of the air, so you've got clean air blowing over your workspace. This prevents other mold spores or bacteria getting into your bags or your dishes if you're working in front of them. Now, until recently, there haven't really been any purpose-built mushroom growing flow hoods available. There are some now, which is good. My one actually cost quite a bit because I'm here in New Zealand. My HEPA filter panels themselves are about $480, with another $40 or $50 for the pre-filter, which is actually mounted behind these panels here. And my fan on top, my blower, was actually about $330, plus another $60, $70 perhaps for my control unit here. So to build my flow hood actually cost me quite a lot of money, probably upwards of $1,000. Now you can get these a lot cheaper, the ones that are available pre-made now. Of course you can make your own still, and making it in America will probably be quite cheap, but if you want to save a bit of time and hassle, you just buy a pre-made.
Again, this is the price I paid to build this unit in New Zealand. Building it in America will be a lot cheaper. You can buy purpose-built flow hoods from Myers Mushrooms in America. I recommend buying one if you want to save the time and making your own. People have pointed out on my flow hood that the sealing foam is facing the wrong way. This doesn't matter because it's present on both sides of the filter. It will cost you about $600 to get a flow hood.
The second would be a good autoclave. Or some people use pressure cookers. You can see mine behind me.
All America makes some pretty good autoclaves. I recommend picking one of these up. The starting price for a good sized All American is about $800.
The third item you really need is a really good impulse sealer, which I've got right here.
My impulse sealer cost me about $230. You want to get a good one. Bad ones don't seal very well and often burn the bags.
And of course, you want This all on a stainless steel benching, which is really easy to clean.
You can get a good size stainless bench from Amazon for about $140.
There are some additional costs in the lab which you're going to have to consider. One is items like parafilm, but it's not too expensive. Another one is sterilized scalpels. Now, I found boxes of 10 sterilized scalpels for $5 per box, and these are all actually expired. But I've been using them for quite some time now, and I've never had any contamination with them, so I think that's still good. Also, a few things like spray bottles, isopropyl alcohol, and paper towels, of course, to wipe your benching down.
Expect an entry-level lab to set you back about $2,000, but you can go over this mark with all the other things you need to buy.
So here we are out in my incubation room. The best part about an incubation room is it doesn't really need to be that pretty. All it needs to do is serve its purpose. Now, the purpose of an incubation room is to keep your mushroom blocks here at a set temperature for a specific amount of time. To do that, all we do is either choose a room that's pre-existing, or if you want to go the hard route, make your own, make sure it's insulated, and get an air conditioning unit for the room. You can see my air conditioning unit right behind me. It's actually behind this fan here. So when that turns on, this fan turns on with it, and it blasts that air, which is either being heated or cooled, straight down the middle of the room.
You can get an air conditioning unit for about $300 and a fan for about $60. Combined with an inkbird controller, this will keep your incubation room at the correct temperature.
At the moment, I've only got one shelf set up in here. I actually had shelves lining this room. I was doing a lot of shiitake. I took them all down because, one, I didn't really want to continue on growing shiitake, and it used up a lot of room for incubation. Right now I've only got this one shelf set up where I put all my oyster blocks on, and each shelf here fits about 50 blocks at a time. Right now I'm doing about 50 blocks a week, so it means that they come in here, they sit in here for 2 weeks, and then they're gone, which means at most I only ever have two shelves filled up. Earlier on today I actually took that whole top shelf, this shelf here, away and put that into fruiting. Tomorrow another 50 blocks is going to come in here and take that place. Next week, these blocks will go.
It is cost effective to make your own, or you can buy ready-made shelving. Expect the shelving to set you back about $300.
The good thing about incubation room is you don't need a lot of stuff to make it work. You don't need humidity, you don't need lighting requirements, you don't need fresh air exchange. All you need is a room where your blocks can be kept warm so they can grow their mycelium nice and quickly.
An entry-level incubation room will cost you about $700. It's very easy to go over this mark if you have to build and insulate your own room.
Pre and post-production. There are some things you must do to get your mushroom bags ready, and there are some things you must do after you've grown some mushrooms. To prepare a mushroom block, there is the expensive end of the scale, and then there's the cheap end of the scale. I'm right at the cheap end, and I just manually weigh each bag before I mix them together. Or the expensive end is where you buy an automated mushroom bagger and you just need to hold the bag open, press a button, and all the ingredients or the substrate gets tipped into the bag for you. The expensive end is extremely fast and you can do hundreds and hundreds of bags an hour. The cheap end is a lot slower, but if you're not ready to spend thousands of dollars on a bagger, it is good to start at the cheap end so you get a hang of things.
To measure my bags, I just use a cheap industrial scale and an automated water meter. These cost about $160.
You can see my homemade sterilizer set up right here, and that's actually running right now. This uses a homemade boiler and homemade steam tanks. I'll put a link to my build for this up in the corner. It's just running off a homemade PID controller, which is controlling the temperature inside that barrel there.
You can make your own, like mine, for about $700, or you can buy a pre-made one for about $1,300.
I run this multiple times per week and it's fairly reliable. I've been using this for over a year now without much trouble. Again, you can buy pre-made steam sterilizers. They are slightly more expensive than it will cost you to make your own. So if you are crafty with tools, I do suggest just buying the parts and throwing one of these together.
Cost for bagging and preparation can range from $700 to about $10,000. The more you spend, the more time you save.
Now, post-harvest, I cannot stress the importance of having a really good commercial fridge. These things here are invaluable, and they go a long way in keeping your crop fresher for longer. You can see mine here now is at 0.6 degrees, and it fluctuates from about 0.6 degrees to about 1.5 degrees. In 1 week, I'll fill up this fridge with a mushroom harvest, with this entire side here being fresh cut mushrooms, And this side here is really kept for a lot of my spawn, plates and cultures.
Expect to spend about $2,000 for a decent commercial fridge.
You're going to need a few other things, like food containers to stick your harvest in, and some more stainless steel benching to cut your harvest up on. All of these add costs to the whole operation, but you do really need most of them. And finally, the cost of goods sold. This is the input cost you have to spend each week to actually get the ingredients together to produce the bags. The three main costs will be unicorn grow bags, hardwood or softwood fuel pellets, and a supplement like soy hulls. You ideally want to use hardwood fuel pellets, but I use softwood here in New Zealand with a degree of success simply because we don't really have access to hardwood pellets. It cost me about $30 to produce 20 mushroom bags. So that's a cost of about $1.50 per bag. My bags weigh about 4.2 kgs each, and even at 50% biological efficiency, we're looking at about a kilo of mushroom out of each bag. In New Zealand, you can fetch about $60 per kilo, which is probably about $40 per kilo. And after we've got all those costs added up, if you really want to be conservative, double it. Starting a small scale mushroom farm isn't that cheap, and there are going to be a lot of hidden costs. You never know, you might have to get an electrician out, you might have to get a plumber out, you might have to buy a vehicle like I've got behind me. There are other costs you need to account for, so please be conservative. But if you are really keen to start one, I recommend giving it a go. It is a pretty rewarding and fulfilling business to run.